Good day, good day, good day. I'm done early today. That is FC Utrecht, because I was at the University of Utrecht and I'm going home-ish now. But yeah, the last couple of weeks I've been back to school, kinda. It's a separate education. Well, I want to say course, but the Dutch term cursus, we are not allowed to call it that way. This is the third week I've been in Utrecht for a different amount of days. And next week, Wednesday, so it's the 25th of April, I will do my exam and after that I'm done. So the meaning is that when I'm done with my exam, I will drive this road and I will continue to ride, follow this road through Houten to Nieuwegein. There's a parking spot there. And from there on, I want to follow the dikes and the embankments all the way to Krimpen or Rotterdam. And everybody is welcome to join me. The estimated time of leaving will be... I'm not quite sure how long it will take me from Utrecht to there. So let's say 12:30 there. Like if nobody comments that he or she will be there to continue my ride. Even if I'm earlier there, because well, if nobody says she's coming, I don't have to wait for anybody, of course. But I think it would be fun if multiple people were to join this group ride. The first group ride of the year then. And I don't have to be in front if you don't want to ride behind my interesting smelling motorcycle. Today we're going to take the highway because traffic jams, although at this moment I don't think there will be a lot of traffic jams because it's quite early, and two, I have a destination that I need to reach within a certain time period, which for me is a little bit more important at this moment. I will just keep the bike at 100 kilometers per hour no matter what the maximum speed is, because longevity of the bike is a little bit more important than speeding or overtaking. I actually kind of wanted to talk about a subject that I find is quite interesting. Some might have seen it that I do play a little bit of Pokemon Go from time to time, and with me millions and millions and millions of other ones, people. But especially with this weather, it's a great excuse to just go outside for a little bit. And there are other Dutch motor vloggers who did a vlog about it. It popped up once or twice in my vlogs, just very shortly. And the reason why I'm bringing it up now is because I have a couple of subscribers in the direct area. And I've met some of these subscribers not knowingly. So they didn't know that I was Myvesto. I didn't know they were a subscriber of Myvesto. But together we were playing Pokemon Go. This mainly happened in Barendrecht, but also a little bit in Rotterdam. Some people I've met before they became subscribers. Then they noticed me driving around Barendrecht and they asked, because I have a similar name in Pokemon, obviously. I'm reusing this name a lot. But I haven't talked to any one of you guys really. So in summertime I will join some race by bike. So in that case you are 100% sure I am Myvesto. And don't be afraid to talk to me. I mean, it also works the other way around. Some people that I met through Pokemon Go are kinda interested in the fact that I ride motorcycle and may or may not become subscribers in the future. I don't know. I have a couple of them who, you know, said they will look me up. I also had an encounter that I talked to somebody that I talk to quite often while playing Pogo. He had somebody with his, I don't know, I can't remember if it was family or not, I'm sorry. And they knew my name from YouTube. That's how small the world is. There's only one person between me and a subscriber of mine. Although maybe not a subscriber, but surely a watcher of my videos. Not everybody that watches videos is directly a subscriber, and not every subscriber is watching my videos. Otherwise my numbers would be way, way up there. So yeah, for some reason, unintentionally, Pogo and motovlogging are combined at different levels. And I find it interesting. So I got at least tomorrow, and I think Sunday, and then probably Tuesday to reread everything, like keep myself familiar with all these materials and all the data and formulas, and I'll master the exam. It's quite an interesting exam because it's 40 multiple choice and you need to have 26 of them at least correctly. So that's about 60, a little bit over 60%. 40 times 2, 26 times 2. 80, 10.5. So 26, 26 is 52 plus 12. Yeah, 64, 65% accuracy. Minimum. I think he said 65 minimum, so. But yeah, 26 questions need to be correct as minimum. And then you have 10 multiple choice questions. And you can score 20 points with 5 multiple choice questions. And you need to get at least 11 points. So 55%. If you fail on one of those two, but the other one is perfect, you still fail. It feels heavy, it isn't really that heavy. There's a traffic jam on the other side, damn it. Why not on this side? Yeah, it feels heavy even though it's not really heavy. It's an interesting subject, it has to do with safety and radiation, so the alpha, the beta min, gamma, neutrons, protons, knowing your atoms and the different states they can be. If they send out radiation by one of the different possibilities, what will mean that for that atom, how will that atom change, that's the basics, and then of course how do we protect ourselves, how do we protect our colleagues, how do we protect the area around you in the environment, how can you calculate how thick net you need to keep everybody safe, and of course big part is also how do I monetize this. So how do I need to monetize this for the law? What are the minimum requirements, etc, etc, etc. It's a subject that I rolled into through job, my work. And I started to like and like and like more. The administration part a little bit less. At this point we are, that's what I'm giving, instructing people how to use certain things. So yeah, a good education above my normal education became a must. So the boss offered this opportunity to me from his own. I didn't have to ask him, and he would pay for it. And I, without further thinking, I said yes. I am a firm believer of that you are never too old to learn. But if you get the opportunity to keep on learning, you should try to keep on learning. Maybe not in this severity, but yeah, be open to learn new things. Hone your skills. There's always new stuff to learn, especially in the medical field and engineering field and the ECT and, you know, stuff that it keeps on refreshing on a yearly basis. There's always new stuff to learn. And I think I talked about everything that I wanted to talk about. Maybe until upcoming Wednesday. It would be fun to do a group ride this early in the year, even though it's a very small one, even though it's a very short one. And I will talk to you guys later. Thanks for watching.